السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن أصدق حديث كتاب الله عز وجل وأحسن حدي حدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر أمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة دلالة وكل دلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah عز وجل. We praise Him and we extol Him and we seek refuge in Allah from evil within ourselves and evil results of our wrong actions. Whomsoever Allah guides can never be left astray, and whomsoever Allah allows to be left in misguidance, and there is no guide for that individual. O you who believe, ittaq Allah, have the consciousness of Allah, and always speak a word that is true. As a result, He will rectify for us our deeds and forgive us of our sins, and whomsoever obeys Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger has indeed achieved a great success. As what follows, my dear brothers in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. For today's Jummah topic, we'd like to speak about the greatest phrase which has come from the Jannah to this earth, and which hasn't been just placed on this earth randomly, but walhamdulillah rabbil alameen, it was placed strategically in the hearts of every true Muslim. And that phrase is the Shahada. And for those of us who are not in attendance for last week's khutbah, then we spoke about the impact that the media has had on a lot of people around the world. But more specifically, we spoke about the impact that the media has had on the Muslims to the point that a lot of Muslims have suffered from many different states of manic and depression and schizophrenia and anxiety and severe anxiety attack. And this is all a result of watching and following the media reports. And we also spoke about the need for us as an ummah to get back to understanding the basics of our deen. Because a lot of us, because we're following, as a result of following the media and not knowing the authenticity of such reports, have become lax in our deen to the point that we're losing focus of what is more important. So we've also spoke about the very fundamental importance for us to get back on the basis of our deen, to understand what is the basics of our Islam. Wallahi alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, all praise is due to Allah in the beginning and in the end. It's very important as an ummah that we understand what is the necessary building blocks for every true and fruitful society. This is why, my dear brothers in Islam, I have chosen the importance of our shahada for the topic of our khutbah today, inshallah, and some of its requirements, bi'idhni Allah. And we're not going to speak about the whole of the shahada, but we'll speak about, inshallah, the first part of our shahada, which is the kalima, la ilaha illallah, and some of the proofs. And inshallah, we'd like to speak about the first obligatory proof in this regard, which is ilm, knowledge, that each and every one of us who profess this shahada must have correct knowledge of its requirements, which Allah Azza wa Jalla said and stated clearly in Surah Anbiya, ayat number 25, where he says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونِ. And we have not sent beforehand or any messenger except that we have revealed to him to say to his people that there is no other deity worthy of worship except Anna, except Allah, and that they should worship him. So my dear brothers in Islam and Iman, for us as a flourishing community, it's very important that we leave off all of the jidal wa khusamat fi deen, that we leave off all of the argumentation and the debating in our deen and focus more on what is fundamental, what is the asas, what are the basic building blocks of every fruitful society. Because for us as Muslims, each and every Muslim, it's obligatory upon us to understand what is the shahada and what are the requirements of our shahada. And all of this, my dear brothers in Islam, for us to understand this, we must know that this is the foundation and this is the spring where all of our deeds spring forth from. For us to know and understand with full knowledge and conviction, what is the shahada and why Allah Azza wa Jal placed it so strategically into the hearts of every Muslim. This shahada, my dear brothers in Islam, is the strongest agreement, is the strongest bond, the strongest agreement that we have as Muslims with Allah Azza wa Jal. This is an agreement that we have professed with Allah Azza wa Jal within ourselves. Today, my dear brothers in Islam, I would like to whet our thirst and our interest for us to want and hopefully, inshallah, we'll study and we'll try and learn some of the basic fundamental requirements of our shahada, bidhnillah ta'ala. And this, my dear brothers in Islam, isn't anything new. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says in this ayat, Surah Anbiya, وَمَا أَرَسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِنَّا نُحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبَدُونِ. That Allah Azza wa Jalla had revealed this kalima, طيب, لا إله إلا الله, to the first of the prophets and messengers, Nuh alayhi salam. And he called his people to this blessed kalima for over 950 years to the end of them and the last of them and the seed of them, which is our Prophet and Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he called his people, and they called their people to this kalima tayyib, this kalima tawheed, which is la ilaha illallah. They all said, ya qawmi a'budullah ma lakum min ilahin ghayr. Oh my people, worship Allah, you have no other God except him. What did our messenger, our blessed messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, call his people to when he was in Mecca? He called his people for over 11 years in Mecca by saying, ya qawmi, oh my people, qul la ilaha illallah tuflihu. Oh my people, say la ilaha illallah and you will be successful. So my dear brothers in Islam, for us to know and understand is the starting point for us to love and appreciate the blessing of being endowed with this kalima tawheed, this kalima shahada. And this isn't, as a lot of Muslims believe nowadays, which is very sad, that this is a special branch of Islamic knowledge which is exclusive for some scholarly individuals from our ummah. This, I must say, that is very wrong notion. It is a very wrong understanding, because this kalima is something which is essential for each and every Muslim to know and understand with full understanding, and then, bidnillah, as a result of us trying to understand our kalima tayyib, then we will begin to love Allah Azza wa Jal more. So how else can we establish this love in our hearts? Is by studying the Asma Allah al-Husna, the blessed names and attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal. And then, bi'idhnillah, as a result, we'll be able to build up the love within our hearts of Allah Azza wa Jal. And then, inshallah, we'll get more knowledge of what is the purpose behind our creation. So I'm hopeful, inshallah, by our reminder today, that we'll gain a better understanding of our purpose here on this earth. And that our purpose here isn't to be stressed out and to be having anxiety attacks about everything that we've seen or heard on the media, not even knowing if these reports are true or not. And this is a very sad reality, my dear brothers in Islam and Iman, that the majority, the overwhelming majority of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do not understand our kalima. We do not understand our kalima. If you were to ask almost any Muslim, young or old, what is the literal meaning, or what is the basic meaning of La ilaha illallah? Majority of them might say, who have some basic understanding of the Arabic, they might say there's no God but God, which is wrong. Or some will be very brutally honest and say, I do not know. I do not know. Why is it, my dear brothers in Islam, that most Muslims, the majority of Muslims, do not know, do not understand, and have not taken upon themselves to understand the basis of our deen? This is very sad indeed. For us, that we do not know the basis of our deen, starting with the kalima shahada, is a very sad reality. And we have Muslims who are getting into heated debates about politics and about who is right and which group is wrong and which group we should be supporting, and some fallacies and notions that they've witnessed or heard about on the TV. This is very sad, because within our shahada, and we're speaking about the kalima la ilaha illallah, it has within it a basic rooted foundation, which is al negation and affirmation. A negation wal nafi, a nafi wal isbat, which is a nafi, negating everything, any other aspect or object of worship illallah, except Allah Azza wa Jal. And the ulama, the scholars, al-Rabbaniyin of the Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah, have stated that the basic meaning of the kalima tayyib, la ilaha illallah, is that la ma'bud bilhaq illallah, that there is no object of our worship, there is no object, there isn't anything that is more deserving of our devotion and our worship in truth except Allah Azza wa Jal. So when you hear Muslims saying that they do not have time to pray, or you have Muslims saying that they cannot fast, they do not have a legitimate Shari'i reason, a legitimate Islamic reason for not praying or not fasting at its correct time, or leaving off the prayer altogether as an adult, it shows that we have lost a very basic asas, foundation of our deen. Because this is part of the fundamental reasons why Allah Azza wa Jal created us, so that we can worship Him correctly. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Muhammad, ayat number 19, فَعَلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ لِذَنْبِكَ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَتَقَلَّبَكُمْ وَمَتْوَاكُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jal, He says so clearly to our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, فَعَلَمْ, that we must know, referring to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to inform us, to inform his followers, and to inform us that we must know La ilaha illallah, and then ask forgiveness for our sins, and also for the believing men and the believing women. And Allah ends off his ayat by saying that he is fully aware of where we are moving. Allah Azza wa Jal is fully aware of our whereabouts and our moving about, where we settle, how we're moving, how we're dealing, how we're moving. In this verse, my dear brothers in Islam, it is very clear that Allah Azza wa Jal is telling the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to know with sure knowledge that there's nothing worthy of worship except Him, and that He should also convey that to us and seek forgiveness for the believers. Seek forgiveness. We have to learn this, my dear brothers in Islam. We have to know this before we try and get our heads twisted up in politics, getting our heads messed up in politics, especially in the world politics. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There's an authentic hadith on the authority of Uthman, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man qala la ilaha illallah mukhlasin min qalbi daqala al-jannah." Uqam qala sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Uthman ibn Affan said, on the authority of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever says, whomsoever says the kalima la ilaha illallah sincerely from their heart shall enter into Jannah. So my dear brothers in Islam, the time when we start to understand this kalima is the starting point where we'll start to understand the purpose behind our noble creation, the purpose behind our noble existence on this earth. This is the starting point of our iman. This is where our iman springs forth from, is our understanding of our kalimatayb. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says at the end of this ayat, وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ, that we should seek forgiveness for the our sins and the sins of our fellow Muslim brethren. Because the majority of the things that we're involved with, which we know are wrong, it's all due to the reality that we have lost focus. We have lost focus, and we do not understand the meaning of our kalima shahada. As we all know, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spent over 13 years in Mecca Mukarramah calling his people to this kalima tayyib, la ilaha illallah. Oh my people, say la ilaha illallah and you'll be successful. His people refused to say this blessed kalima, which we all know. They refused him and they drove him out. They were very annoyed at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for asking them to say this kalima. Why was it that they were so annoyed with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for simply asking them to just repeat this? Ya qawmi, qul la ilaha illallah tuflihu. Oh my people, oh my dear people, just say this word, say this phrase, la ilaha illallah, and you'll be successful. Why is it that his people who knew him sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who grew up with him, and seen how he was and how he was acting amongst the other people, they called him al-Amin? Why is it that they refused to say this simple phrase, la ilaha illallah? It wasn't simply due to the fact that they understood the linguistics of this phrase. Because any of us can look up the words and break it down linguistically. La ilaha illallah. It wasn't that. No. Because we have the Christian Arabs. The Christian Arabs, they say La ilaha illallah. So it wasn't just that. But there's a lot of shurut. There's conditions. Because those mushrikeen of Quraysh, they understood that by saying this kalima, La ilaha illallah, it had with it some conditions. That they couldn't lie anymore. They couldn't cheat. They couldn't swindle people out of their wealth. They understood. And they couldn't abuse themselves and they couldn't abuse others. So they understood that by saying, by professing this kalima tayyib, La ilaha illallah, they had to change their ways. They couldn't be the same. They could never remain the same after saying this. The companions, as we know, the companions of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they were put through severe persecution when they resided in Mecca. Why? They were persecuted. Some of them were even killed. Why? Just simply due to the fact that they professed this kalima tayyib, La ilaha illallah. They were driven out. They were boycotted. They were socially boycotted for over 3 years to the outskirts of Mecca. Why is that? Because they professed this kalima, La ilaha illallah. To the point that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and that small band of believers, they had to sustain themselves and feed their children crushed leaves for 3 years. On the outskirts of Mecca, they had to sustain themselves by crushing leaves and mixing it into a mortar paste and feeding it to their children. And they had to sustain themselves for that period on the roots of trees by squeezing the juice of the roots of trees and making a drink out of to nourish themselves and their children. Why were they put through this severe persecution, my dear brothers in Islam and Iman? Simply due to the fact that they uttered this phrase. They believed in this phrase. And those people who resided in Mecca could not stand to have such people residing amongst them who were saying these words, and they followed up what they said by doing good deeds. They professed those words and they followed it up by not cheating, by not lying, by not trying to swindle people out of their wealth. And this is the old age saying, which goes back to the olden days. And it's very relevant in our day and age today, where we're seeing so much lies on the news and amongst ourselves that we should do unto others as we'd want done unto ourselves. This, my dear brothers in Islam, is very serious because we have millions and millions of Muslims who have said this out of astonishment, La ilaha illallah, when they see something astonishing happen or they hear something astonishing. But it's very sad that the majority of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has yet to understand the meaning of the kalima tayyib, La ilaha illallah. There's a very, very beautiful proof of the importance of this kalima tayyib. And that Allah Azza wa Jalla didn't just throw this kalima tayyib frivolously into this dunya. And it can be found in Surah Ibrahim, ayat number 24, where Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Alam tara kayfa daraba Allah mathalan kalimatan tayyibatan ka shajaratin tayyibatan asluha thabit wa far'uha fi sama'i. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Alam tara, have you not seen how Allah Azza wa Jalla sets forth a parable, a mathalan, a parable, as a good word, which is La ilaha illallah, as a good tree, that its foundation, its roots are firmly fixed, and its branches reach to the heavens. And Abdullah ibn Abbas, commenting on this statement, مَثْلَ كَلِمَةٍ طَيِّبٍ, the parable of a good word, is the testimony of faith, La ilaha illallah. And the statement, كَشَجْرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ, as a goodly tree, a good tree, refers to the believers themselves. Allah Azza wa Jal chose this kalimatun tayyib and he placed it into the heart of every true believer. Asluha thabit, whose roots are firmly fixed into the ground, which indicate the testimony of faith. La ilaha illallah is something which should be firmly fixed into the hearts of every true believer. وَفُرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ, and the branches of that kalima tayyib, which is rooted in our hearts, it reaches to the heaven by way of our good words and our good actions. This is a clear indication that the good deeds that spring forth from our hearts, reach to Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is the starting point of our understanding of this kalimat tayyib. So may Allah Azza wa Jal give us the tawfiq and understand that this kalimat tayyib is something that has not just been thrown frivolously into this world, but it has been placed strategically into the hearts of every truly practicing, believing Muslim. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us of those. أقول قولي هذا صفحة وعطوب إليه. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه الهدى وبعد. My dear brothers in Islam and Iman, also as Muslims residing here in the West and living amongst so many non-Muslims and so many non-practicing Muslims, we have a very strong obligation upon ourselves and upon our community first and foremost, and upon our fellow neighbors, our non-Muslim neighbors, to present a good impression. Give them a good impression of Islam. Because we have many Muslims today that involve themselves in debates with the non-Muslims. And this isn't the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. You'll never ever find in the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, you can go and check and see that the Prophet ﷺ engaged in any kind of debates with the mushrikeen of Quraysh. He used to speak to them with kindness. So my dear brothers in Islam, it is not from al-hikmah. It is not from putting things in their proper place. It is not from wisdom and from correct speech that we make our starting point of da'wah to be engaging with our non-Muslim relatives or co-workers or neighbors about jihad, about the hijab, about any type of thing which is politically inclined. We should make our starting point be La ilaha illallah. As we mentioned at the very beginning of our khutbah, that this was the starting point. This was the call of all of the prophets and messengers. And there is a well-known hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said, that the Prophet Nabi Musa ﷺ, he said, speaking to Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, "Oh my Lord, teach me some words that I may remember you by." So Allah Azza wa Jal, Kalim Allah Musa, spoke to Musa and said, "Say La ilaha illallah." So Musa alayhi salam said, "Oh my Lord, all of your true servants, they say La ilaha illallah." So Allah Azza wa Jal said to Musa, "If the seven heavens and those that dwell within it and the seven earths were put on one side of the scale, and this kalima, La ilaha illallah, were placed on the other side of the scale, then this kalima, La ilaha illallah, would outweigh it." And there's another hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said, and the foot of Jabir ibn Abdullah, that the Messenger of Allah ﷺ said, "Afdala dhikr, La ilaha illallah." The best form of dhikr, remembrance of Allah, is La ilaha illallah. وأفضل الدعاء, the best form of supplication, is Alhamdulillah. As we mentioned, my dear brothers in Islam, that it is very important that we understand our kalima, that we understand that this kalima is the key to Al-Jannah. This is our key to opening the door of Al-Jannah. And as any other key is, it has teeth. The key of Al-Jannah is this kalima, La ilaha illallah. If one chip is in any key, then it would not be able to open the door. So I would like to leave us off in closing with some of the basic conditions of the first part of our shahada, La ilaha illallah. And as we mentioned in the beginning, our shahada and the kalima, La ilaha illallah, has within it a nafi wal ithbat. It has a negation and an affirmation. And it means لا معبود بالحق إلا الله. That there is nothing worthy of worship in truth except Allah. And it has come with conditions. And the ulama al-Islam, they said that, some of them said that there are eight, but the Raji, the majority of them said that there are seven. The first that every Muslim must know is that we must have knowledge of the meaning of this kalima. We must have knowledge of it and what it entails. That none has the right of our worship and our devotion except Allah Azza wa Jal. Our work, when it's time for salah, basically, we have to put it aside and offer our salah. We have to offer our salah. We cannot say, I do not have time to pray. Because this is part of us negating our shahada. And secondly, we must have yaqeen. We must have certainty that Allah Azza wa Jal alone is the one to be worshipped. That our worship with yaqeen. We must have yaqeen that Allah Azza wa Jal alone is the one who deserves all of our worship and devotion. And thirdly, we must have ikhlas. We must have sincerity to this kalima shahada. We must be mukhlas. Mukhlasin lahu deen. We must be sincere when we profess this kalima shahada. And we must say it with sidq, with truthfulness. We must be truthfully believing what we say in our inwardly and outwardly, in word and in deed. And we must accept it with full acceptance in what it means and what it entails. And sixthly, we must submit, taslim, as we say that we are Muslims. Muslim is one who's musallim, that we submit. This is the first requirement, that we say that we are Muslims. But how many of us have truly submitted to this kalima, la ilaha illallah? And we have to have hope. We have to have love. La iqra' fi deen. There's no compulsion in the deen, in religion. There's no compulsion. So I'm just trying to whet the stone. I'm trying to whet our desire that we can go out and learn and study. What is this kalima, la ilaha illallah? Why did Allah Azza wa Jal choose me? Why did Allah Azza wa Jal choose you to be a carrier of this kalima? Walillah alhamd. We have to first be grateful that Allah Azza wa Jal chose us and placed that seed of iman in our hearts. And it's only by our recognition, recognizing that Allah Azza wa Jal had chosen us. And then, bi'idhnillah, we will start to take the necessary steps in the right direction and do the necessary good deeds so as to please Allah Azza wa Jal and to show that we are truly appreciative of this. And then, inshallah, we will develop a love for Allah Azza wa Jal. So may Allah Azza wa Jal bless us and give us all the tawfiq to make this our starting point of developing the love of the shahada. And then we'll put aside our petty differences. We'll not be stressed out. We'll not suffer from anxiety attacks when we put the love of this kalima into our hearts. So may Allah Azza wa Jal bless us and bless our families and guide us to all of those deeds that Allah loved and is pleased with. Inna Allahu malaikatu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallam tasliman. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. Rabbana zalamna anfusana. Lam taghfir wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Wa aqimus salat.